गुड आफ्टरनून डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन इन योर संस्कृति वर्चुअल क्लास। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ योर चैप्टर नंबर 2 ऑफ मोमेंट्स, दैट इज एडवेंचर्स ऑफ टोटो। यस्टरडे आई टोल्ड यू दैट इन दिस स्टोरी ग्रैंडफादर बॉट अ मंकी फॉर द प्राइस ऑफ 5 रुपी फ्रॉम अ टोंगा ड्राइवर, एंड वी ऑल्सो स्टडीड दैट ही वॉज a mischievous monkey and his presence was hidden from grandmother. Now in this story the writer or the author has also described about two incidents in which he has displayed the mischiefs or mischievousness of the monkey. So let's begin with the first incident of this story in which narrator has described about the mischievous of Toto. So one day Toto almost boiled himself alive while trying to bath. One day as he used to take a bath daily, so what happened one day that he boiled himself in the water. He saw a large kitchen kettle left on the fire to boil for tea. How did he got boiled? Because as he entered in the kitchen, he saw a kitchen kettle left on the fire in which the water was boiling for tea. He removed the lid of that kettle and found the water warm enough for a bath. He got in with his head sticking out from the open kettle. A little while later, the water began to boil and Toto raised himself but sat down again since it was cold outside. So as the water was on the fire, whenever we keep something on the fire or over the fire, so naturally it will boil. As it was water, so as the temperature raised, it kept on boiling up, and he was a monkey, he don't know that whether to dip his head or not. He dipped his head in that water and that water started boiling more and more as the temperature was raised. Then he hopped up and down many times till grandmother came. So as he boiled his head in that water, and it was quite hot water, so as whenever we also get burnt, so we used to panic or we used to hope here and there because of that pain or because of that burnt. So he also was dipped in that hot water. He used to hope here and there till the grandmother came. As the grandmother saw, he took out half boiled Toto from the kettle. Now let's begin with the second incident of this story. In the second incident, the writer recollects another incident when Toto created a lot of mischief. At lunchtime, a dish of rice was placed on the dining table. When the family reached to eat, they found Toto eating. So in the second incident, what happened? As all the family members in grandfather's family were sitting at the dining table for having their lunch, so there a dish of rice was there which was placed on the dining table, and when the family members reached there, so what all they saw? They saw that Toto started eating that rice, and that rice was pulao. The writer's grandmother screamed at Toto, and in response he threw a plate at her. So as the writer's grandmother saw that Toto has started eating that rice from the plate, so he was eating continuously. Seeing this, grandmother screamed, grandmother shouted at Toto, and as grandmother shouted at Toto, the reaction was Toto, or the response was Toto, was he threw a plate at grandmother. When the aunt arrived, tried to catch Toto, he threw a glass of water on their face. After that, aunt also tried to catch Toto, but what did Toto done at that time? He threw a glass of water on the face of aunt. Seeing all this, as grandfather arrived there, Toto left the place through a window with the plate of rice with him. Toto remained out the entire afternoon. He sat on a branch of the jackfruit tree, determined to eat all the rice. As the grandmother had screamed on him, he wanted to annoy her further, so after eating the rice, he threw the dish. It broke into several pieces. So as grandmother was shouting or screaming over Toto, so what he did, he threw that dish also, and that dish was broken into several pieces. Then finally grandfather realized that Toto was not suitable to be kept at home. They could not be afford the frequent losses that he gave them. He tore clothes, curtains, wallpapers and broke dishes. So the grandfather sold Toto back to the same tonga driver for the sum of 3 rupees. So this was the story of the adventures of Toto. In this we have studied that a monkey is always a mischievous one, because the nature of monkey is always to do the mischiefs. Here the chapter is over now. Thank you.